If in a mass transport accident like plane, trains, ship, in some cases like 9/11, US attack, where all the people in there were destined to die, what happens to those souls who had still not finished their journey? They all hang till the regular time comes, understand? Whether it is murder or accident, till your time, the natural time is ending, you have to wait for next body. You have to wait for next body. Only one thing, if you are not consciously accepted, you will not have suffering. Please understand. For example, you have come down to the planet Earth, this is creating a body through you 100 years. If somebody dies by suicide or murder, 60 years, they have to wait 40 years for the next body. If it is a suicide, that 40 years will be hell. Worst suffering, understand? Worst thing you can do is suicide. Never ever contemplate. Actually, it will be worse than the present situation. Suicide is not courageous. It is fear of escaping from life. Somebody asked a question, why these people commit suicide without bothering about near and dear ones? It's not courage they commit suicide, ma'am. You ask from where they get the courage. It's not courage, it's actually cowardice. They are afraid of life, so they escape. They want to change. They don't know anything else, so they take suicide. I tell you, suicide will be the worst thing. Your consciousness will suffer at least 100 times more. If you are murdered, if somebody is murdered, not suicide, even then they have to wait for the body that same time, but there won't be suffering. They will be in a peaceful way. They will be just put inside, maybe you can say, anesthesia. They will just put in castle body. They will put to rest. So never ever contemplate about suicide. That is the worst thing. And just imagine, such a wonderful food is in front of you. Neither you have tongue to eat, nor you have hand to pick it up and put it in the mouth. How you will suffer? Same way, person who committed suicide, the whole world will be in front of him, but he can't enjoy, he can't live it. That is why he suffers so much without any body. He just goes around and sees, is there an empty body? If you live without fully aware of your whole body, naturally what do you think? After all, half of the body is empty, you live in one corner, I will live in another corner. And they catch your body. That is how the possessing happens. If you are completely aware of your whole boundary, live with the full consciousness, you will never be possessed. You will not be caught. Otherwise, wear the mala. I have already made agreement. They should not touch whoever is wearing mala. Please understand. I can say this is one of the important secrets. Ghosts are actually lower level, low energy jivas than you. You have 7 layers. They have only 4 layers. They do not have the first 3 layers. Physical, prana and mana. Physical body, mental body, pranic body. They don't have the 3 layers. So actually, they are only 70% of your energy. Only they need to be afraid of you. You don't need to be afraid of them. But the problem is, your fear empowers them. The moment they see that you are afraid of them, they just take you for granted and try to possess. So if you are not bothered, if you don't have fear, then nothing can be done by them. They cannot possess or they cannot do anything to you.